Welcome to Life as Usual, a video blog dedicated to making you a more impactful leader through the ideas of self-awareness, execution, and direction. Today, I want to talk about the power of good pressure and how it can improve your work tremendously. Have you ever wondered why you get better around deadlines? That you get more motivated when the pressure is on? It goes back to our fight or flight reflexes. We're really good in the clutch because human beings survive when the pressure is on. Good news, you can utilize that power in the work that you're doing. You just gotta be okay with a little risk to make it happen. What is reverse charity? Reverse charity, in the simplest form, is you having to give money or time to a cause that you absolutely hate. Sometimes hate is a more powerful force than love, especially when things are superficial. I don't want to give money to the Ku Klux Klan, but if I want to stop drinking soda, and the consequence of that action is giving money to the Ku Klux Klan, guess who's going to stop drinking soda? Or guess who's going to write a blog post every day? Or guess who's going to start going to the gym? You can add this to as many things as you want. Reverse charity works because it works with your fight or flight. You don't want to be caught dead doing that. What types of pressure can I use? There's a lot of different types of pressure you can use. I talked about reverse charity, where you give your money to a cause that you hate. There's also something like claiming something publicly. You don't want to make yourself a liar. But if you say you're going to do X and you achieve it, well, it looks good. And, of course, you didn't make yourself a liar. A master of this is Elon Musk. Elon Musk loves to talk about things he's going to do publicly before they happen. And then he puts himself on the clock to make it happen. Can you combine all these things? You sure can. You can combine reverse charity, your public claims, you can combine telling your friends, you can combine an accountability partner, you can combine a bet, right? We all know what bets are. You can combine all types of things to make these interesting, tough pressure systems that'll make you get the work done. The most important thing to know is you're in charge of it and your brain can't tell the difference. Use that to your advantage to get more interesting work done. How do you provide this in the frame of self-awareness, execution, and direction? Self-awareness. You have to be aware that your fight or flight mechanisms are at the base of what you do. Before you have anything else, before emotions, before rational thoughts, it's fight or flight. We're survivalists. Using these tools takes advantage of that so that you can get more interesting work done at a quicker time. Execution. I love being proactive, and if you've seen any of my videos, you know that's a big theme of what I do. So, in order to be proactive, find a list of charities and find a list of consequences that you're comfortable with and start testing them out with either your accountability partner or your work today. Once you have that list, use the comment section in this video as a public claim space. State what you want to do and when you want it done. And then state the consequence that you're comfortable with. I'll be checking in on you to see how it goes. Direction. All of these things are useless unless they're compressed in a way that you can connect to a goal. Make sure that the pressure is a thing that pushes your goal forward, and that the consequence isn't too bad to take you out of the game. You don't want to do something ridiculous, like say, I'm betting $1 million on black if I don't get to such and such. Try to find things that are within your budget that'll make you hurt, but not make you go crazy. You want to be aware that the fight or flight mechanisms exist in your head. You want to execute on finding what gives you pain and tell us something that you're going to do right now in the comment section. And then you want to make sure that whatever the consequence is, isn't crazy enough to ruin your life. You want these things to sting, not take you completely out. Remember, pressure turns coal into diamonds. And if you want your work to shine like a diamond, you better find the right pressure to put on it. If you look in the description box, you'll find a couple of books that helped me dive deep into emotional intelligence. They've had exercises, research, and deep dives that helped me bring these concepts to you. This isn't a one-way conversation, and in fact, it's not a two-way either. We're part of a community, the Life as Usual community. And as leaders, especially creative leaders, emotional intelligence is something that we all need to get better at. We can reach out to each other through the comments section, through sharing this video, through liking it, and help each other talk about, build upon, and explore these concepts in these videos. Remember, I'm not just a teacher, I'm a student as well. Help me learn your perspective.